boxing has the weigh-in. Tennis has the somewhat awkward photo op the day before the match. This one certainly feels like a heavyweight match. Roger Federer, number one for about 15 months. Rafael Nadal, the fast-rising Spanish player who will turn 19 tomorrow on the day of the semifinal. We go now from the roof of Chatrier to the basement as Roger Federer joins us. Roger, what happens when you and Rafael get together at a photo opportunity? Like, did you tell each other your life stories or just say hello? Is it seem a little strange?
Yeah, we just say hello. We talk and say, how's it going today? And, yeah, just be all relaxed and, like, there's nothing up tomorrow, you know? Like, we haven't seen each other for a while, you know? Just meet and greet, basically. But today, you know, for the photos, it's a little different. You almost smile on command a little bit, but it was okay. You know, he's a relaxed guy, and it's good to do things with him like this.
Well, you walk out the semifinal in one of the most anticipated men's tennis matches in a long, long time. People are comparing this to Agassi versus Sampras in the twilight of their career. Obviously, you guys are both relatively young, but is it exciting to be part of something this anticipated, perhaps the birth of a big rivalry?
Yeah, I feel there's something really special in the air, you know, and they're really promoting this match as much as they can. You know, the photographers and the TV stations waiting for just this one picture of the two of us together was quite unbelievable already. So I don't want to know how it's going to be tomorrow once we get out on the court, you know, but that is what it's all about, you know, when the best face off against each other, especially two big favorites in a tournament like this. And but don't forget, you know, it's our first semifinals at the French Open for both of us, so this is a big occasion for us.
It certainly is. You guys have played a couple of times, and Nadal has a game that gives a lot of guys difficulty, including yourself. He beat you the first time, and then, of course, there was that epic match down in Miami where he was just 2 points away from winning the match, and it seemed like you had a very difficult time early in this match kind of reading his game. What is it about Nadal's game that is especially concerning?
Well, it's just a lefty game, you know, which is very different. You know, he moves very well on the court, and plus, you know, he's got an unbelievable spin on the ball, you know, so it makes it hard to control it. I had a really tough time in the beginning of the match against him to try to attack his ball because he had so much spin on the ball. So once I got used to that, you know, I started to play better. But, you know, on clay, we'll see how much time he gives me. So it will be interesting to see.
You've been asked whom you fear, and you said no one. Why should I fear anyone on any surface? But some would say that he has no fear of you either. Maybe he's too young to know better, but do you sense that this guy is not the least bit intimidated to play you in a Grand Slam semi?
Well, I have the feeling he looks up to me quite a bit, you know, so, but I don't think that will play any role in that match we're going to play each other. We have a lot of respect for each other, and I think we're big admirers from one and the other's game, you know. So he's young, you know, he's got nothing to lose, even though the expectations are high. And similar thing for me, you know, they consider him maybe the little bit bigger favorite than myself. He talks it down, says I'm the big favorite. So in a way, we've got nothing to lose, and we really just hope we can live up to this very important moment.
Well, speaking of gamesmanship, I mean, do you take it into consideration that you're playing an inexperienced player in terms of Grand Slam semifinals? I mean, do you try to use that as a weapon? Do you try to get in his head a little bit?
Well, I think I definitely have to use my experience to hopefully come through. I'm always usually very, very good once I make it so far in the tournament. Okay, the Australian Open, I lost it with a match point in 5 sets against Safin. So I hope I can change that again and win that semi-finals, you know. But he has lived through some big moments as well in his career already, like the Davis Cup final in front of 27,000 people, which was a record in tennis, you know. So he's used to the big moments, and I always have the feeling that also in the big moments he plays his best as well. So I'll be expecting a really tough match.
Rightly or wrongly, this will be viewed as the final. The winner in your match will be the heavy favorite on Sunday. Do you dare to contemplate completing the career slam at such a young age, something only Agassi has done on different surfaces?
Yeah, I mean, I know the importance of this slam, so for this reason I'm very excited. But I'm really focusing first on the Nadal match, even though I know I'm very close to the title, but I'm still many forehands and backhands away from that. So let's focus on the Nadal match first, and then we'll see if it's really going to happen.
We're happy to do that. It's great for tennis. We wish you guys both play well and live up to the hype of this match. Thanks, Roger.
Thanks very much. Bye-bye.
1938, when Bugs became the first man to win
a calendar Grand Slam younger than Federer, should he go on and win this title and complete the career slam. And it will be Federer on the line to open this semifinal match.
Start the match. Are you kidding me? Great serve out wide, the transition forehand, and Nadal on the dead run with the clean winner. Holy mackerel.
Let's hope that's a portent. That puts a hit.
I really think that the court positioning is going to be a huge factor today. Federer's ability to take the ball early, to step inside the baseline there. He went behind Nadal. I think that's going to be key. We watch how that develops. Well, we also learned, though, Dick, in the match that Federer and Nadal played early this year in Miami, is that Nadal's not afraid of Federer, as a lot of players are, understandably. Keys, I think, to the match for Federer is his court position, as I talked about. He's got to be offensive, and he's got to use that variety in his game. He's got to use the backhand slice. I think he has to serve and volley a bit. Not allow Nadal to go on the offensive.
Points early for your birthday boy.
Nadal's keys, Dick, to winning this match, can dictate with the forehand, attack Federer's backhand when he can. And I think it's going to be important for Nadal to get a high first serve percentage. And second serve is the weakest part of his game. That's an area where Federer can jump on the young Spaniard.
Federer has protected his serve well throughout the championship in his five matches, broken only seven times. The break in the opening game of the match.
The other thing I was saying earlier, Dick, that we learned from that Miami match, he's not intimidated, but he went after Federer's forehand in that match. He wasn't afraid of that. He hit a lot of balls into Federer's forehand corner, and even in that first game there, we saw a couple of errors from Roger on that side. Look at this, 22 matches in a row. Losing just seven sets in that streak.
If he should win today, that will equal in the Open era the most wins consecutively by a teenager, Andre Agassi, back in 1988, won 23 straight. Nadal could tie it today. Least of his concerns, he begins his serve with the lead.
There's that shot going with his forehand. See, Federer is immediately looking to move to the backhand corner. Nadal goes right at the forehand side. There are the scores of that meeting in Miami.
And Nadal led 4-1 in the third set, up two sets. And in the tiebreak in the third set, had a 5-3 lead. So he was close to beating Federer, and then Roger wore him down.
We missed it.
Federer showing you some good defense. Coaxes the error.
Okay.
Part of the pre-match talk was the weather conditions and how the court would play. Most feeling that with all that heavy top spin that Nadal would benefit from a hot, dry day. We've had some rain in the middle of the day, as you can see, still some ominous clouds off in the distance.
I don't think it's extreme either way, Dick. It's not. Obviously, we have a little dampness.
Yeah, all dampness.
That would soften the court a bit, but the sun now out. It seems to me like it's sort of right in the middle.
And so far, Nadal showing a high kicking shot making that's troubled Federer. Better be ready to hit the ball up above your shoulder playing this young Spaniard.
Chess match from the back of the court. This time Federer goes down the line. As you can see, Nadal, just like Federer, will look to camp out in his backhand corner so he can hit the forehand. So both players will really look to go to each other's strength to surprise their opponents, get them on the defensive. Smart Federer was there, Dick. He had a chance to come to net, but he didn't hit a good enough shot. This next one right here, he wanted to come in. He didn't hit it good enough, so he backed up. He retreated, waited for the next one. That's the versatility he has in his game, the ability to just step back. Look where he hits that from. About a foot, a couple inches inside the baseline.
For Nadal for two love. Plenty humid today. Playing after 6:30 in the evening Paris time.
Well, they finished one match early in the first week and well after 9:30 p.m. so. Assuming it doesn't get wet out here, I have plenty of time to finish this. Above the shoulder of Federer on the backhand side.
Avantage Nadal.
But again, it was Nadal's ability to hit his backhand hard cross court there. Open that shot up for him. Then make Federer move quickly over to the backhand side.
Secures the break, leads to love. Let's go to Hall of Famer Pam Shriver.
day like today can really throw the players off. In the case of Roger Federer, he warmed up for this match over 6 hours ago. It was during the rain in the middle of the day, and his coach Tony Roach said it was an abbreviated warm-up. And when I saw Tony about an hour ago, I asked, did Roger go back out and hit it all? And he said no. Whether or not that's a great idea, I don't think so. And given the slow start, I think perhaps he could have gone out and just hit another 10, 15 minutes. But who's to criticize Federer?
Or the Hall of Famer Roach. Coached Yvonne Lendl to many successful Grand Slam wins. Pat Rafter as well. Reliant on his wisdom. First double fault.
From Federer, they're trying to get his rhythm going, kicking the serve in, and then attacking that first ball.
Roger was upset in the third round a year ago in this championship by Guga Kuerten. One jewel left to complete his Grand Slam crown. Just dominant on grass and hard court. These are the Grand Slam events, and you can see his record sparkling by his standards, average here in Paris. 70 and 19 overall, the total. And the ace down the middle.
I think we all felt, Dick, that once Federer won his first Wimbledon 2 years ago, that, you know, that he'd sort of gotten over the hump, but we didn't realize he would just vault over it. I mean, with his dominating performance last year, winning three in just ridiculous fashion.
2-1, Rafael Nadal in the lead. 1,000 is the capacity, but there is not a seat that's empty, and the aisles are full as well throughout this wonderful structure. It surrounds the brick rectangle. Terre battue. Nadal 2-1. The French Open has been the roadblock for so many outstanding players, many of them Hall of Famers. Won the other three, but not here in Paris. Ash, Newcomb, Connors, Becker, Edberg, Sampras, Federer, John McEnroe could be on that list as well.
And he didn't win the Australian, but neither did Borg, because in their day, they rarely played in the Australian. It was not nearly at the level of the other majors. Something tells me that the two of them probably would have picked up a title there if they'd been there every year.
That would be a pretty good guess.
Yeah, on the grass. That's a good play from Nadal. When he's getting something short, he's looking to attack.
See the action on that ball? Mm-hmm. I was breaking away toward the sidelines.
Generates so much spin with all that racket speed that Nadal has. You see how he, many times when he hits his forehand, he brings the racket straight up. Sometimes he comes across his body, but oftentimes, particularly when he's on the move, he hits the, he makes contact and the racket goes straight up into the air.
And, easy hold.
Surprised that Federer has taken some good cuts on the second serve so far of Nadal. He's a little sluggish. That first point of the match sort of set a tone, didn't it? Nadal with an incredible forehand pass.
Federer looking for his 25th title in the last 3 years. Nadal with his 5 this year and 1 on clay last year.
Oh. this surface, Federer is a little more, rather than serving and volleying, he's more comfortable serving and then taking that first ball. And that's a good play. It's very hard to serve volley because of the difficulty in the movement and adjusting a net. That was always a thing that bothered Sampras. That bothered my brother John, Becker, guys that look to serve and volley pretty consistently. Get the same footing. Ooh, that's a terrible shot there.
Yes.
Federer's definitely not feeling it so far. And Nadal's come out just like you'd expect him, Dick, just on fire.
Well, he's been consistent, hasn't he? Every point of every match.
And there's a serve volley play, but Nadal was very good with the backhand return. He's able to get it down low. And that's not a good enough serve. And then Nadal with plenty of time as he shows you that hook forehand passing shot.
Boy, does he flash when he gets to full speed on that second step. Forehand, it's 1-3, 30-all.
That's the combination that Federer is looking for. Again, he's inside the baseline, and most deadly shot in tennis when he gets that ball in the forecourt. Although maybe we might change that after we watch Nadal's today in this match. He takes care of some short balls himself. When we miss hits, over hits it.
And another break point for Nadal.
Ten unforced errors for Tony Roach's guy, Federer, just three for Nadal.
And the Spaniard is up double break, 4-1.
Term life, annuities, long-term care. I can't make any sense of this. Can you do it?
I did a checkbook.
I'll play you for it.
There's no question. Understanding insurance and investing is difficult. At Genworth Financial, we're dedicated to making things clear. So when you're ready to figure it all out, we'll be there to help. Whenever that may be. Genworth Financial, the right approach to insurance and investing makes all the difference.
The road of life takes many turns. There are over 900 Chase credit cards to help you make the most of every one. Your choice, your Chase.
I don't believe there's anything that can keep my family happy.
It's not mine.
During an 8-hour car ride on our family summer vacation.
That's cool. Oh,
could I say that just one more time?
Circuit City is the one place to go for portable fun this summer. In store or online, we'll help you make the right choice. All at unbeatable prices, guaranteed. Circuit City.
And welcome back to Paris, where Roger Federer, the world's number one player, down a double break to the 19-year-old sensation from Mallorca, Rafael Nadal, serving 4-1.
Federer needs to play a good game here, Dick. He's clearly rattled and struggling. A normally reliable forehand. We showed you the unforced errors. 10, 6 of them on the forehand side.
And again, that in part He's trying to read this kid's shot making with so much spin. Federer saw the ball wide. Umpire Cedric Maurier from France. And shot spot confirms it's wide. Double full, love 30, an opening for Federer.
Rushing it a little bit, trying to find that swing. He's so precise, Federer, and when he's on, he's pretty much unbeatable. But when he's off, he can make some errors. He usually gets it back together, Dick. Usually can find it. But the problem is this youngster he's playing is going to take it to him.
Cut the line. And here's Federer's first chances to break.
Very slow first serve there from Nadal, just 93 miles an hour. Here's a chance where I think Federer can step inside and try to be aggressive with the forehand. So Federer had to adjust his swing at the last second. That's one of the problems for Federer's game, Dick. When you are so precise, those bad bounces, and that ball skidding doesn't have quite the same margin for error on his shots as Nadal does. He's been groomed on this red clay since he first picked up a racket. Also been groomed by some pretty darn good athletes around him.
Some in his own family. The net cord really helped Nadal. Federer did a great job of reading the drop shot. He had all day to get there, but the net cord foiled.
Snuck in right there, Federer. But again, that's the precarious position for a volley or Dick at net on this surface. You can't quite get your footing. You're a little off balance. You've got to be in a real offensive position to finish the point at the net. Give Nadal an extra look on the pass and you can forget it.
Federer. Plenty of blue skies. The one ugly dark cloud that appeared to have some rain in it moved off to the side of Roland Garros.
So they understood the importance of this match, huh, Dick? We've all been waiting for this for a few days.
What has been so ideal the entire 2 weeks of this French Open, and the only real serious rain was it in the morning and noon today.
Great serve from Nadal. Put a little extra pace on that. We haven't seen too much from the youngster in the pace department, but that one at 120 miles an hour on the first serve and just deadly with that forehand.
Any feel is outstanding, as you can see already, the talent of Nadal, that his serve is going to get even better. And then, how high will he rise?
Well, that's going to be the X factor for him, Dick, on the other surfaces, on the hard courts at U.S. Open and on the grass at Wimbledon, if he can improve that. That's where Federer has to be. Getting Nadal on the run and controlling the points with his forehand. Starting to find his range, Federer. Swiss fans looking to get their guy going.
That country, as Roger pointed out, just 2-3 hours by car away from Paris. He grew up on the red clay.
Federer gives Nadal a taste of his own medicine.
He breaks and earns one of those games back.
Federer shows that he can do the same thing, defend, get the ball down, and then give himself a look at the pass. And boy, does he move into this beautifully. On the run, adjusting the steps, and then just flowing through that passing shot.
Beautifully low he was. Oh,
that's, you've seen that a few times on those grass courts, haven't you?
Chris, he'll be the favorite when the action swings to Wimbledon in 2 weeks. I think Nadal's ready to make a dent at Wimbledon with his game.
I think he's ready to win a few matches, but I'd be surprised if he makes it real deep. But I wouldn't underestimate him, Dick, no. His competitiveness is, he's got good hands. Obviously, he gives up a lot of court on the clay. We'll see him be able to adjust that. But no, I wouldn't put him as one of the favorites. Obviously, Federer is the clear favorite, and then you've got Hewitt, Roddick. Maybe Safin, if he gets his head together over there.
Nice thing about Nadal, though, he's said all along, that's the championship he wants to win.
Isn't he from Spain?
That's right. Most Spaniards say this is it, the red clay of Paris. They grow up, you know, wanting to play and win this event. But Nadal, no, his eye is on Center Court Wimbledon.
Spanish fans would love to have a little more cheer about on the grass. Federer struggling with his serve, only winning 28% of the second serve points.
That's a couple
loose points,
yeah,
huh?
That he's pulled wide. 2-4, 30-all, opening set. Roger Federer from Switzerland. Mallorca, Spain's Rafael Nadal.
Got to get those second serve points better, and only winning 50% of the first serve points, so that's not too good either.
Bitten twice by the net cord, Federer. And it's a break point for Nadal to get back that two-break advantage. A little unlucky for world's number one on that point. Missed first serve.
Got it on the line.
We dusted that sideline, taking away the break point. Now, for those of you joining us that have not been following Roger Federer for the last couple of years, not only the world's best player, but perhaps the world's most popular player, not only with fans, but with the press and with the men he competes against.
Oh, that's terrific.
And that deep.
So good, Nadal, the way he can slide into the ball with the two-hander, which is so difficult to do, and he's so far back. Look how she slides into it, and he's still perfectly balanced. And as you said, Dick, well behind the baseline enough to get, still gets the power on it for the passing shot.
Another break point for him.
himself as he misfires again from that forehand wing. And Nadal will serve for the opening set when we return to Paris. Court Central of Roland Garros. Roger Federer, we mentioned early on that he had been broken only seven times total in his first five matches of this tournament. Broken three times by Nadal in the opening set. Nadal 5-2.
He really hasn't found the rhythm yet, Federer, particularly off his best shot, the forehand.
Well, in Miami, he lost the opening set 6-2 to Nadal, and this is very much the same, isn't it?
And he said, after that match, he said, you know, it's pretty unusual for me to lose a set that badly, 6-2. Another forehand error.
He won Hamburg that precedes the French Open and didn't drop a set. And he has not lost a set through the first five wins of this championship. So 11 straight matches without sacrificing a single set, but he's 3 points away from losing now, 2 points from losing this opener to Nadal. There's his record to the semifinals.
Moya was struggling with a shoulder problem. Gonzalez gave him a couple of tight sets, Nescu the Romanian, but I gotta tell you, Dick, I'm pretty surprised. Nadal's not even doing a lot. He's just basically keeping the ball in play. I mean, he's hit a couple of good shots, but for the most part, Federer is just missing.
Yeah, the best shot of the entire set was the opening point.
First point of the match, exactly.
5-2, 30 all.
Federer is usually his footwork is so crisp, Dick, and so on, and just not quite there. The confidence isn't there again. Way overhitting that one.
His 17th unforced error. Atypical set being played by the world's number one, and 10 of those errors from the forehand.
Could he be feeling the pressure? Is it possible?
First set point.
That Federer is just doing too much thinking right now. He's wondering what shot to hit. Should I play the slice? Should I try to get to net? Nadal is playing. He's going on his instinct now from being so comfortable on this surface.
Keeping the ball in the center of the court till he seizes any possible opening. Shot effective for Federer. Second set point gone for Nadal. These are two terrific athletes, folks. Part of the excitement of seeing them go head to head here in the semifinal is that they both do everything so well athletically.
Federer.
Now it's Federer that has the break point.
Breaks of serve already. Some opening set. Nadal looks like he's going to change the rackets. Usually the players do that out for the new balls, Dick. And that previous game, Nadal serving with new balls. Federer needs a good service game here. He's really struggling on that serve.
Yeah, to be broken three times in this opening set just is puzzling. Most of the problem from his own series of errors, especially on that forehand.
Not good. 43% of first serve points. That's why he's been broken three times. Again, tough to get your footing there.
On grass, that serve would have been effective enough for a fairly easy volley, but not on the red clay.
Look at this. 4 of 11 for Federer. Serve he's hit today. Good action on it, went after it. Federer is really a rhythm server, Dick, when he gets that going. 127 miles per hour that last first serve. Part of the reason he hired Tony Roach was to help him prepare for the majors and particularly this tournament. And that's where Tony has played his part, Dick. Serve and volley a little bit more. Be a little more aggressive. Obviously, you have to pick your spots, as he's found out quickly in this match.
The pace from Nadal. And Federer again. Often his timing and the forehand error.
But again, Federer is not as dominant when he's moving to his right into the forehand corner. That's where he can make some errors, and Nadal's going after that.
Oh, wow. There's been 40-15 to Deuce.
What happens is, Dick, you then, because you get passed a couple of times early, you start to say to yourself, if you're a volley, I've got to do more. And he took a big swing at that volley. He really just needed to punch it, but he remembers being passed.
In this troubled game, forced Nadal to serve for the set at 5-4.
Oh, hello.
What a shot. Kick serve out wide, Nadal. Look at the way he controls that. Incredible topspin on that shot.
Right over the net post.
That's an amazing swing. Looks up as if, yeah, no problem. Oh, yes, that's great play from Nadal.
Could he possibly break Federer's service again?
He gets the chance to go on the offensive, setting it up. A heavily topspin forehands, and then he opens it up for the winner.
Third set point.
And there it is, 6-3 to Nadal. You'll have to scramble for a lot of patience to find Federer losing four service games.
Before the match, but the different body language, Federer smiling as usual, relaxed stuff. And there's Nadal. It is very much like a boxer getting the instructions right.
Roberto Duran. And you know what? We got a little heavy rain right now. This is maybe what Nadal likes.
Is Nadal sprinting back to the baseline? We have a full-on sun shower about to happen here. It is.
Action. Opening the second set, Rafael Nadal.
You expect Federer to try anything differently here, Patrick McEnroe, or is it just a matter of getting the ball in the court?
Yeah, I think he's just missing. I think he's maybe trying to finish the point a little too quickly, but he can't play, you know, he can't just push the ball because that'll allow Nadal to go on the offensive. See right there, you know, that's Federer's not comfortable running out to that forehand side, and Nadal's taking advantage when he gives him something short.
Federer committing 18 unforced errors in that opening set to 10 for Nadal.
Yes.
The wind is blowing left to right from Nadal's end, and many of his misses have been toward that sideline and whipped wide, undoubtedly helped by that 15 to 20 mile an hour breeze.
I think the wind is a little tougher for Federer to deal with. Doesn't have the same topspin and margin on all of his shots that Nadal has. Still, I think that little bit of rain shower should, Dick, help Federer, because I always, we've been saying throughout the tournament that the slightly damper conditions, the heavier conditions, seem to suit Federer's game. He gets his footwork going. He doesn't slide around. And, you know, Nadal's bounce on his topspin shots won't be quite as effective.
Well, we saw that against Sebastian Grosjean, the only set that he lost.
Federer is just sort of reaching at that back end. He's not really stepping in and going after it. He's trying to guide it. And once you try to guide the ball, particularly on this surface, you're going to have all sorts of problems.
Tony Roach, the winner of this championship back in 1966.
Racket speed is so important in tennis now, but even more so on this surface, Dick, where you've got to go after your shots, you've got to generate your own pace, and Federer hasn't been able to find that range at all yet today.
This sellout house at Chatrier, they're shocked into almost silence here. They're wondering what is happening.
I'm not at all shocked at how well Nadal's come out and handled the occasion, but clearly Federer is not himself at the moment, and whether he's feeling the pressure, whether, you know, it's hard to see sometimes on TV, and when you're even watching up here, the weight of shot that Nadal gets on the ball. That's why he's been able to dominate so much on the clay. His ball is a heavy ball, and he gets all that topspin. So maybe Federer just feels like he can't get on top of the ball enough in the rallies, but he was able to do it in Miami. Remember, he was two sets down. That was a hard court, yes, but pretty slow hard court.
Well, he's got to begin taking care of business on his own serve, being broken an amazing four times in the opening set, held just once.
Interesting there, he sort of told himself, don't stand, don't get so far back, move up a little bit into the court. Federer, I think, would be well served to continue to try to serve wide to get Nadal off the court.
Federer last year winning Australia, Wimbledon, and the U.S. Open, losing in the third round here, and was the heavy favorite to start this season in Melbourne, but was knocked out in the semifinal by Murat Safin. And as Pam pointed out, perhaps a bad omen. Safin was celebrating his 25th birthday on that night in Australia when he beat Federer 9-7 in the fifth. And here is Federer again at the table of a birthday celebration, at least planned to be so by Rafael Nadal, who is 19 on this day. One all in the second. The amazing speed of Nadal. How few could get to that ball well wide of the doubles line.
Federer at his best, just controlling it with the forehand. Yeah, look at Nadal. I mean, he just hustles after every single ball.
As Mary Carrillo pointed out earlier in the championship, it's as if every point is the final point, the way Nadal plays with such a vigorous attitude.
Match with Safin, Dick Federer had match point in the four set tiebreak and lost it. And then Safin made an incredible get on that point and then won it 9-7. And then also against Gasquet, the young French teenager in the quarterfinals in Monte Carlo on clay, Federer had a match point.
Lost 8-6 in that final set tiebreak. So to say his two defeats out of 48 were close losses is gross understatement. I mean, he's a couple of shots away from being unbeaten. Pam, what do you have for us?
Well, I just talked to Tony Roach, Federer's coach, and from Tony's standpoint, just the amount of unforced errors from Federer's racket on big points are just so unlike him, and he obviously needs to tighten that part up, especially on the forehand side. I'm not sure Tony's seen him hit his forehand that poorly in a set. Really wants him to put more top, more work on the forehand, get it high up to the Nadal backhand, and then step into the court and get aggressive.
Federer using every shot in his book, and that time the dropper effective.
And he followed it in, Dick, which is a key, because then you're taking the angle away from your opponent.
And the doll saw him coming.
Big point right here. Federer can get an early break here in the second set. That might be enough for him to get his confidence going.
Ah!
is the example, Dick, of what Pam was just talking about from Tony Roach. Federer played about three heavy forehands there. A lot of action on the ball, played some defense, worked his way back into the point with the topspin there. That's the ability of Federer to read what's going on in the match. He's made so many errors on the forehand. He's got to just look to get some consistency.
First break point of this second set for either player and a second ball to Federer.
Well, that could turn things around there. That's a big game for Federer.
Have returned quickly to Paris to be here for this semifinal match.
No against.
His father, Sebastian, mom, Ana Maria, is a couple of fans to his right. There she is.
Looking pretty good after that long trip from China, huh?
Young. Rafael's sister. Tough play made to look easy by the athletic Federer. They're far enough away that they can talk in sign language.
Too nervous to sit next to each other. We've seen that before.
Biggest match of their young son's life on his birthday, playing for the French Open final. Has a set lead, but down a break here in the second. Oh my, that ball flipped off the frame. The ball not taking any chances, made sure that it landed on Federer's end.
And that heavy topspin from Nadal. You're trying to take that ball so close to the baseline, and Nadal gets that depth. That's very difficult to time it, particularly in these breezy conditions. Oh, speaking of ballet, often see some balletic moves from Federer. There was one.
That'll please that big band of photographers clicking at every move.
Full stretch, able to carve under that ball. He knew he had to play it short because Nadal was off to cover it. Well, Federer seems to have it going now. I heard a little come on from him. Starting to feel it, maybe.
Federer, who is fluent in German, French, and English, consults and is interviewed in all three languages, gives an hour just to be interviewed by the press and television from all the countries of the world, speaking the various languages, and that language is universally known. Brilliant.
Sure, exactly, Dick.
Trying to square this match at a set all, but plenty of work to be done. Let's see how Nadal handles being down 1-3.
Nadal with zero winners in this second set, with Federer playing with more consistency. That game there was the best game he's played in the match from Federer.
Yeah, he really dictated every point, didn't he?
And it's very much worth going back to that previous game after, you know, we'd heard from Pam and Tony Roach about playing with some more margin on the forehand. That one point was really key at 30-all. At one game apiece. Got Federer a break point. Now he's starting to flow.
And just as Nadal seemed to have Federer totally off balance the entire first set, now it's Roger's turn.
Well, when he's on Roger Federer, he's unstoppable. And he's starting, it's the button starting to get to the on level.
Yeah.
his heart.
Nadal, much like your outstanding baseball left-handed hitters who are right-handed in all the rest of the activities of life, but bat from the left side. Same with Nadal. He's a lefty only in playing this sport.
Nadal at Nadal's game now. Looping the ball, playing defense, opening up the court. And to be perfectly honest, Dick, if Federer plays like this, I'm not really sure what Nadal can do. He doesn't have the firepower if Federer's game starts clicking.
Here's two more break points for Federer to jump out 4-1.
It's the first time all tournament where you get the feeling, okay, is the young Nadal going to start to press or to try to go for two, for more?
Puerta rallying from two sets to one down.
And 2-4 down in the final set, Dick. Got broken to 2-3 and then ran off four games in a row.
Davydenko appeared to run out of steam.
Yeah, he was tiring.
Another break chance for Federer. Just as Nadal built a double break lead at 4-1. Girlfriend Mirka Vranic.
Shades.
Also the manager of Federer. They've been together more than 4 years now.
Good combination there from Nadal, the slide serve out wide and then the backhand cross court.
Approach from Federer, and Nadal hurrying his shot, knocked it long. Another breaker, four now in this game for Federer. Federer of a double break. Five titles all on clay this year. Second in history, Tomas Muster, 95 and 96. And in 95, Muster continued right here at Roland Garros, won the French Open Championship. Heavy hitting Austrian.
Oh,
what was that?
That was a fake drop shot. He thought about hitting the drop shot. And then at the last second, this is like they do this at the country club, you know, in the parks. Here, let me fake you out. Amazing.
Hey, wait a minute. You're number one. I can do this.
Yeah. I guess he's starting to feel a little better about his situation in this match.
Well, his forehand so far off in that opening set broken four times, and when Rogers asked how he evaluates his game and his strength. He said, well, my forehand, it never lets me down. It's always there. Mm-hmm. Well, it wasn't there in that first set.
Now he's trying to toy with Nadal.
Oh, my.
Toys R Us time. Just to send a little message to the birthday boy. Don't blow out those candles yet.
You want to see my cape?
This is just downright abusive.
So Nadal down a double break, 1-5.
To do. He's got to try to get inside the court with his forehand and try to flatten it out a bit. Federer's been able to pin him behind the baseline throughout this set. Of course, a lot easier said than done.
Along with his many honors, Roger Federer voted the Sportsman of the Year in the world. Received that honor before coming here to Paris.
Oof.
Beating out names like Lance Armstrong and Tiger Woods.
That's the biggest serve I've ever seen Nadal hit. 128 miles per hour. Not surprisingly, his first ace.
And his double fault is his second. ESPN's continuing coverage of this French Open Championship. Well over 100 hours brought to you from Paris, much of it live. Roger Federer serving at 5-2 for the second set. After Rafael Nadal breaking Federer's serve four times in the opening set, grabbed the lead 6-3. Problem child for Federer in that first set. Many of those forehands flying long.
Well, he's tidied things up a lot in this second set.
Hasn't he? Only 8 unforced errors in this set. 18 in the first set.
Well, Nadal, of course, spends his time way behind the baseline. This is where he's returning serve from. And look where Federer is trying to pull him out wide in both courts if he can. And that's making Nadal have to get back and cover so much territory. Federer is so good in that midcourt area that he can take that ball quickly and really keep Nadal on the move, on the run.
Double fold for Federer is his third.
And a much better job, Federer, on his serve in the second set. His numbers in the first serve percentage are way up. And winning a lot of easy points on the first serve.
There's no quitting this young guy. He'll battle even though down double break, and he has a chance to break back on this coming point.
She broke Federer four times in the first set, and Federer has upped his serve percentage considerably. 84% in the second so far. Down the first break point in this set.
Here in the second set continues. He serves 3-5. See if that buoys his play. It seemed apparent we were going to play best two of three. Built for 19, Nadal is. He is a package.
Great play. Oh, just drops it in. He's a good aggressive 1-2 punch, but Federer is able to get over there quickly and on the run, just guided up the line.
Philippe Chatrier, packed. Around 16,000. Watch this much anticipated semifinal. Any wondering just how good Nadal is being tested by the number one player in the world? He's been the best player on clay, that's for certain, coming in 36-2 this year. Card on clay this year, Nadal by far the most outstanding record. David Ferrer, his countryman, he beat him here at Roland Garros. Coria, the Argentine, and Davidenko, who lost in the earlier semifinal, the top four clay records.
First, Federer's wasn't bad either, 14-1, but he's not playing as many events. Pacing himself, he won the one of the big warm-up events in Hamburg. Of course, Nadal won the other two big ones in Monte Carlo and Rome. Three Masters Series events on clay.
And Barcelona before that. Well, this is exactly the mirror set of the first set. One player takes the two-set lead, loses one of those breaks, then has to serve it out himself. And we'll be ready to head across the channel to London and Wimbledon. Play beginning 2 weeks from this coming Monday. Roger Federer serves for a set all at 5-4 here late in the second, 3 points away.
Again, another wide serve from Federer. Himself a cheap point. And that's what Nadal sort of went away from early on in the second set, going after Federer's forehand. And starting to do it. In the second set, he's working his way back into it. Can he come all the way back, though?
He was 5-1 down.
volleying. Very tough first volley. Nadal, again, he's always able to get that backhand down low. And Federer, he loses his footing slightly, but just gets enough on it so that Nadal's not in good enough position to really get a lot on the pass. Just carves that backhand volley cross court. Well, that's a great combination there.
And with it comes two set points.
A little extra pace on that first serve. 125 mile an hour. And ripping the forehand.
Set apiece, 6-3 to Nadal in the opening set, 6-4 Federer in the second. Set apiece is the world number one able to steady himself in that second set. Brad Gilbert, if you're coaching Rafael Nadal, what do you tell him?
Start going your forehand into Federer's forehand. I thought in the second set he got a little bit tentative and Roger started taking it to him. Federer handed him the first set. He's not going to hand you another set. You got to go win it. Get aggressive, take it to him.
One other little subplot here, it's closing in on 8 o'clock in the evening here in Paris. They can play tennis till about 9:15, 9:30. They've been averaging a little bit more than 40 minutes a set. If you extrapolate that out, that means if these next two sets are long, we're going to be getting near darkness. And if it does go five, unlikely, very unlikely to finish it.
Today. A sleepover match.
A sleepover match. They waited 2 days to play this match. Can Paris possibly stand a sleepover match?
I think they wouldn't mind it. Yeah. Carry over the next day.
All righty. We've had some momentum swings back and forth. Federer able to kind of regroup after that brief rain delay. We've seen that happen before at Wimbledon when Andy Roddick had the upper hand and suddenly the rain delay, which was much longer, Federer turned it around. He was getting taken off the court by Leighton Hewitt at the Australian Open last year when the fireworks kind of disrupted things and Roger was able to steady himself.
Well, after the first set, he got broken four times. There was about a two-minute rain delay. That actually gave him time to regroup and relax, made the court a little slower with the wetness, and then right back to business. And if I'm Nadal, you got to think that Federer, like I said, handed you one set. You're going to have to go earn these next two.
Back to Dick and Patrick for the business of set number three.
All right, gentlemen, an hour and 26 minutes to play the first two sets. And that's best 2 of 3 for the French Open finals.
Ooh. Footwork there from Federer. Trying to play that short little backhand slice. So good, Nadal, on this running forehand down the line. Tremendous acceleration with that head of the racket.
Federer enjoyed that one. He was on defense the entire point. Listen to this crowd.
Honkins.
I think that's what they came to see, Dick.
You mentioned he can go from defense to offense so quickly, and there was a brilliant case in point.
Not a lot on that second serve, only 81 miles an hour, but he sort of short and wide, and Uncle Tony, coach of Rafael, says, okay, this is the way we want to start set number three. He's been aggressive with the forehand in this game.
He's coached Rafael since age five. Very close-knit family.
Good, on the line.
And Federer wisely using Nadal's speed to his advantage, playing behind him. Well, it's not only Uncle Tony, but there are mighty good genes in this Nadal clan. His other uncles here as well, Miguel Angel, who is an outstanding defender in football, FC Barcelona. He played in the three World Cup teams for Spain. And Nadal holds to open the third. We live in a four-story home across from the church in downtown Manacor, the second largest city in Mallorca, the island off the coast of Barcelona. And the godparents or grandparents are one level, and the uncles are at another, and the parents at another, and the kids are at another.
Traditional Spanish household, huh? There's his dad, Rafael's father.
Sebastian. What a proud moment for them. Yeah, he started the season a bit below the radar, number 51 in the world.
Hasn't taken him long, though, Dick, has it, to burst up this year?
Talk about a meteor.
Huh.
From January to the end of May, from 51 to 5th, and he'll be higher than that after the French Open. That's got to be a pretty tough challenge for even Federer to be able to try to slice a high-kicking shot like that.
That's a shot that probably only Federer would try. It's that difficult. He made a couple of mistakes on it.
To get to the spot.
Almost overran it. There in so much time. Federer with a couple of brilliant shots during that rally gave Nadal a chance on the pass. And how he tightened up the net game. 13 of 15 points he won in that second set. Oh, yes.
That's good.
Oh, so accurate.
So accurate, it's annoying.
I mean, this ball's up, it's up high, too. Look where he hits him from. About shoulder height, and he's able to get that acceleration on the ball.
Inside the line. And throws in an ace. One all in the third. One set all.
That's his shot. I always sort of, when I read his game and see where he is, if he's serving well, if the serve starts to get flowing and he's holding serve comfortably, then I think it really boosts the rest of his game. He starts to feel like he can take more, take more swings at the ball, be more aggressive, take some risk.
And in that first game of the set, he was 5 for 5 for serves.
Oh, yes.
Third double for Nadal. It is two defeats this year out of 48 matches, both in the semis.
He's so tough to beat when he gets deep into the tournament. We showed that semifinal stat. How about the 19 straight wins and finals?
Oh, it's third. 19 straight times in the finals, and he's 19-0. And we did a little arithmetic ourselves. Since Wimbledon 2003, his Grand Slam record is 43-3. Number one, Roger Federer. With that effort.
Nadal, this is a key point in the match for Nadal. He's because Federer is starting to get the game going. He's got to weather this storm. He's showing a lot of energy here, Nadal, and he's got to go after every shot. Not just even go for a winner, but try to put all that spin, all that action on the ball. Otherwise, Federer is just going to dictate each and every point. Deep hitting there from Rafael.
And then it hits the baseline as well to activate even more unpredictability on the spin. Down on the crushed earth of Paris. Nadal, 2-1, the round serve in the third. Dead even at this juncture on serve in the third, a set all. Winner to meet Mariano Puerta, the Argentine left-hander. He is remindful of Mooster.
Tough guy, strong.
And nothing to really surprise us once this match settled, although the first set had some brows raised.
I just wonder, Dick, if maybe Federer could he feel pressure? I mean, think about it. He loses in the Australian Open in the semifinals, a clear favorite there after winning three majors last year. Obviously, he's the best player in tennis right now, men's tennis. He's dominating the tour. He's dominating all the top 10 players. Well, what if he loses this match? Then he's lost three matches all year. Two of them have been in majors. And despite the fact that he's dominating, then he goes into Wimbledon with all, you know, another pressure that, hey, you know, it's like Pete Sampras used to say, a good year for me is winning a major. A great year for Pete Sampras was winning two majors in a year. So I think that's where Roger Federer is right now at this stage of this match. Because clearly the winner of this match is a huge favorite going into the final.
Well, he wins 3 out of 4, makes it look so easy. Last year, you expect him to win a couple every season, but here he's upset by Safin in Australia, and what if Nadal takes him out in this semifinal? 30-15 on Roger's serve at 1-2 in the third.
Oh, yes.
In the slams, there's Pistol Pete Sampras, the all-time champion with the great Aussie Emo, Roy Emerson with a dozen, Borg and Laver 11 each. Of course, Laver lost 5 years in his career as the game went from amateur to professional, and Big Bill Tilden with 10. And Roger Federer holds for 2-all. Many remarkable stories in the Quinella French to Wimbledon, and you think of Borg winning 6 times here in 7 years, and then going to Wimbledon in those same years and winning 5 in a row on grass, and to make that adjustment so incredibly successfully is just mind-boggling. Two all.
I like Roger Federer's chances of pulling that off just a little more than Mariano Puerta's.
Or even Nadal.
Nadal, exactly.
There's a big league forehand.
Just get the feeling, Dick, that Federer is just about ready to blow this match wide open. Just starting to find his range. When he does, play that safe, heavy forehand and wait for the right shot. The point is there for him.
A
Oh. At least he's gotten himself in an offensive position, but Nadal working so hard to stay in these rallies. And he's willing to pay the price, young Nadal. Such a physical player out there.
Certainly belies his years, May 19 today.
That's a great shot.
He has so much game at such a young age.
Again, getting Federer out to his forehand side, and that opens up the opportunity for him. That's just a beautiful shot. Look how much feel he has to carve under that ball. Richard Gasquet said after he lost to Nadal in the third round match, Gasquet said, "I still feel like I'm a boy." They're the same age. He said, "But Nadal is a man, physically. In addition to his mental capacity out there, how he handles these situations."
Nadal, both men breezing along on serve in the third. He's digging in, and a lot of fans around the world are digging him.
That's for sure.
No break here in the third. Federer 2-3, a set all.
This semifinal building possibly to something very special. And Nadal, bold enough in Australia to come out with a new look. The pedal pushers, whatever you want to describe them. I saw your brother wearing those the other day in practice.
Oh, yeah? That must be quite a look, yeah. Okay, sir.
We first saw them in Melbourne. We kind of looked askance, but
come on, admit it, Dick. They're sort of growing on you, aren't they?
They really are. It's amazing. The better he plays, the more that outfit. I can remember hustling out to get that Bjorn Borg outfit when he had the kind of that beige with a red. Oh, I thought that was
good luck. Yeah,
it didn't help my game a bit.
Well, as long as you look good.
Yeah, I did. I learned just to walk around the club and strut.
There's that combination again, Dick, from Federer to serve out wide. And Nadal giving up so much court. Federer able to step in and crank the forehand into the open court. Nadal's that far back. He's got to really get great depth on the ball and height over the net, so he can give himself some time to get back into the center of the court.
Even on the second serve, look how deep he is. There have been no break chances in this entire third set. Each man handling his serve with relative ease. 40-30.
Sure, Mariano Puerta is back enjoying just kicking back, hoping these guys will go five sets after his five-set win. Get into the final. Oh, what a shot.
Puerta kicking down the door to get into the finals, his first ever Grand Slam final, unseeded. left-hander from Argentina. They had two Argentines battle for this title a year ago, and the surprise was Gaston Gaudio. Maybe Puerta has another Argentine special to cook up against the winner of this one.
Gaudio was unseeded last year.
Chance. The first goes to Nadal. Third, 4-2.
And Nadal set it up with a great return high and deep, and then that allowed him to get quickly on the offensive. And he's not afraid to get up there and finish at the net.
Let's go down to Pam.
Well, Dick, I'm with a very interested spectator, the coach of Mariana Puerta, who, of course, is waiting the winner of this match. Andre Schneider, well done, but how's your guy feeling, both physically, emotionally, mentally?
Yeah, thank you very much, and he feels so exhausted. He played a lot. Today he finished really tired, but he is so happy.
Obviously, he's going to be the clear underdog no matter who he plays, Nadal or Federer. Do either of you care which one of the two you see in the finals?
Yeah, we really don't care too much. I mean, Mariano has to play his game, and they are both very good players, the best in the world, and we have to be fit to play against them. I mean,
I know you've been very busy with your cell phone texting people back and forth, but you've also been watching this match. What do you look for as a coach to then tell Mariana Mariano in the finals?
I watch more, and if he, I try to look. I try to not have something new. I mean, we want to know exactly what they're doing in all points. That is the more important for us. Then Mariano, he's playing always his game. I mean, nothing special.
Well, congratulations and good luck at the final. Dick, Patrick.
Thank you, Pam. Coach pointing out that his man, Huerta, a five-setter to eliminate Guillermo Coria, and then another five-setter today. And both men appeared to be exhausted, even more so Nikolai Davydenko, who had a chance to win it, was up 2-1 and up a break in the fifth. It's Nadal with a break lead here in the third, 15-all. Cry of anguish from the 19-year-old. His fourth double.
Big game right here. Federer can get the break back. If Nadal holds, he's a couple games to play with. Oh. Look at that defense from Federer. Nadal hesitated with good reason, because Federer just ripped that backhand. Look where he is. Nadal stays back and gets caught, and then Federer gets the easy forehand.
And two break points.
Thank you.
next tear for Rafael is tear for Roger. He breaks back.
Slam. Federer serving now, trying to hold strongly after his break back.
Pretty unusual shots in the last few games. He had one forehand in the previous game that he just looked like he was venting some frustration when Pam was talking to Puerta's coach. Federer usually goes after that one a little more. He just sort of pushed it, and the net court hurt him clearly. He just looks to be second-guessing himself slightly on a couple of these swings, Federer. Of course, Nadal, no way. He's going to do that on clay, second-guess himself.
Second serve coming up, and he's had some problems today.
Wow, look at that, 29% second serve points won. From Nadal that he can get that ball down low. He was at full stretch on the run. This one right here, still able to hook it low. And boy, did Federer catch a break here, because Nadal had a lot of real estate up the line with the pass. Remember, he went back there the last time down the line, so he tried to pull it cross-court, but Federer read it.
Serve and volley for the number one in the world. Gets him to game point for four all.
And the opportunistic Dick Federer with those approaches to the net, picked the right time and paid off handsomely there at 30 all.
As long it is four all. Rafael Nadal trying to continue the excellent play here in Paris for the Spaniards, champions in the last 11 years. Sergei Bruguera, Carlos Moya, who is the mentor and close friend of Nadal. They're both from Mallorca. Albert Costa, Juan Carlos Ferreira. Nadal, they feel next in line. The evidence, and of course, the greatest Spaniard of all, Manuel Santana. Jimeno, Bruguera twice, and then Moya, Costa, and Ferrero. Ferrero involved in what may have been the best match of the men's championship thus far against Murat Safin a weekend ago. Safin beat him, and but fell in the next round.
A
losing to Tommy Robredo, another Spaniard.
Yep. Died down a bit, the wind. Very calm. Little different story, Dick, for the Spaniards in Wimbledon as far as winning titles there. And Manuel Santana, only title won there. It was back in 66. But Nadal, he says, hey, that's the one I want to win.
Yeah, he likes the idea of being the best and being different. Yeah. You know, you can see that in his style and his dress, his game, attitude.
His pre-match warm-up routine on the jumping around. Oh, look at that defense.
Oh, wow.
Does he get so much on that full stretch forehand?
He has the ability, Federer, to shift to another gear when he has to. Talk about speed and then getting enough on it. Look out here, Rafael Nadal. How big is this moment for all 30 all?
Guessed right, had a good crack at it.
And there's so much work on the ball from Nadal that even when you guess right and you're standing there, it's still so tough to handle.
See the physique that Nadal has, huge biceps, powerful legs. Between the Place de la Concorde at one end, the Arc de Triomphe at the other. Well, triumph, that's what's on these two chaps' minds, as Federer, with no room for error now in this third, serving at 4-5 to extend the set. Sweet. 8:30 in the evening in Paris. Probably an hour of sun left.
Oh, Nadal. He's jacking himself up now. And he's so good on the move with the backhand pass. Federer, you've got to make that approach count.
Such a good server, and Nadal made Federer earn it. Unlike Puerta and Davidenko, who had to play five setters before their match today and a day less off. These two men have 2 days to recover from their quarterfinal matches. Number four in a critical spot here for Federer to commit the double fault. 15-30. Percentage is so low for Federer, and here's another second serve.
Oh, that's brilliant.
He's so smart.
Dick, I was just saying, talk about playing with maturity and smarts on such a big point to play the dropper and then to be there at net.
Two set points for Nadal.
As Federer wrong-footed him, and Nadal, in his eagerness to cover the court, hits the tear batoo. Another set point for him, though.
I don't think this kid minds getting down and dirty a little bit, hitting the dirt. You know? He's got the mentality of an outside linebacker.
Like the red dog Federer here and win the set. Still got some grit on him, so he's asked for the towel. Getting late, these fans. Been here, it's been a long day.
I mean, Federer smiles. He knows how rough this crowd is. He full respect between these two. Go for that backhand there, Nadal. Had Federer on the defense. It's so precise, the margin between these two right now.
World's top player saves two set points. But his first serve percentage here in this game, not good. For a third chance, Nadal to take a two-set-to-one lead. Federer making a brilliant defensive play in the middle of that last round.
Nadal putting so much work on the ball now. He's climbing all over Federer.
Two sets to one for Rafael Nadal. Seven breaks of the Federer serve in the first three sets here. The seventh break, the most important, drawing a huge vamos from Nadal and also from Uncle Tony. And Federer, the world number one, will have to dig very deep if he's to get out of this hole and get on to the final on Sunday and continue pursuit of the career slam. Just further proof of the specialness of Nadal, Brad. I mean, there's Federer serving at 4-5. The crowd, Roger behind him, and Nadal comes up with the goods after giving back a break earlier in the set with a very loose game. A
lot of maturity, a drop shot and in, and to close out the set. Most guys might have let that ball drop, swing and volley. Seven breaks of Federer serve take you about 3 months usually.
So Nadal, let's see if he can close it out in four. We've talked about the fading sunlight here. It was unlikely we're going to get five sets in. So if Federer can push this to two sets all, unless it's a very, very quick set, likely to carry over to the next day.
I'm thinking Nadal's thinking about this set. And the thing I like most about Rafa there, he went back to the forehand, his lefty from the middle of the court to the Roger forehand. Roger hits his forehand so much better when he's moving around to the backhand side than he's lethal. He went into the teeth, it paid off. Rafa's feeling it right now. The crowd is trying to elevate Federer. I love Rafa's chances here to close it out.
Nadal certainly seems immune to the pressure, but Federer, when he's been pushed like this before, it has brought out the best in him. Back to Dick and Patrick, set number four.
All right, Chris and Brad, and of course in Miami in their meeting earlier this year, it was Nadal taking the first two sets, 6-2, 7-6. Then Federer fought and barely managed a 7-6 win in the third set, and then rolled victory 6-3, 6-1. He's going to have to produce another comeback today to make it to the finals. Nadal opens the fourth.
I'm surprised we haven't seen a little more of that from Federer during this match, Dick. Attacking that weak second serve of Nadal. That second serve was just 78 miles per hour. And maybe we'll see the world number one employ that strategy a bit more.
Federer broken seven times. That was the total for the first five matches of this French Open for Roger. Testimony to Rafael Nadal's game and desire.
Must feel like you're playing five guys when you play Nadal on clay. He's everywhere.
Spins that one wide and earns his second ace.
Second serve ace.
A lot of moxie for this young guy.
Oh, man. He's just eating it up, isn't he, Nadal? Rising to the challenge as Federer got his game going in the second set, but Nadal coming back in this third.
Well, when Federer broke him after being broken himself, looked as if Roger might be stealing the momentum, but it wasn't to be.
Of Nadal now.
Changing speeds and spins Federer, but Nadal holds at 15. Well, Pam Shriver covering the coach's corner.
That's right. Just spoke to Tony Roach again, Federer's coach, and still disappointment for Coach Roach on how Federer is playing the big points. And he also noted that the first three service games of Nadal in the third set, Federer, like he did in this last service game, had love 15 but can't seem to get to love 30, and that's huge in order to break the Nadal serve more. And also on the temperament side, Roger's getting a little more peeved than normal, and it's just because he's frustrated with his inconsistency and not playing the big points well.
All right, thank you, Pam. Federer to serve now. Love one.
Well, Federer basically gave away the first set with a ton of errors. He tidied it up in the second, and not as many in the third as well, but still minus 11 in the differential, and Nadal just minus two.
But if you pointed out so often on the slower clay surface,
yeah,
you're going to
happen. A lot more points will be won by errors than on other surfaces.
So many of long rallies, and finally one man commits the error. Not the point here, as it's 15 all. It's about the only thing he's dribbled today. Forehand that slid him down, and that's his favorite side.
Yeah, that's the surprise, I think, that many on the forehand.
Ah. And can you credit some of that to just chasing a left-hander? And
for sure. And it's just, as I've been talking about and as Brad pointed out just a couple of minutes ago, Nadal's done a very good job of going straight at the Federer forehand. So that will cause a few errors, but he still missed a lot of mid-court balls. Now, certainly a lot of that has to do with respecting the movement and the defensive abilities of Nadal. Got to go for a little bit more.
Good depth on that volley to set up the winning point.
Go. Yes. Great serve volley point. It was not an easy first volley. Two game points for Federer. The other thing that you have to take into account when you look at unforced errors, particularly against someone like Nadal on this court, Dick, is all that, a ball that even we look at from up here or down on or watching on TV that you just miss from the baseline. It's got so much work on the ball, so much spin, that to me that should be more of a forced error than necessarily an unforced.
That one, you can hear the effort Nadal putting into every swing of the racket. Federer has lost the first two sets of the entire championship here against Nadal to drop behind 2-1. The man serving has lost only one set. That was to Sebastian Grosjean over a controversy and rain, and the fans really getting on the umpire and through the umpire to Nadal. But he is quite capable of going the distance, evidence of that in Rome.
Oh, yeah.
There's a slight opening for Federer at 15-30 in Rome against Guillermo Coria. It went five torturous sets, 5 hours and 14 minutes.
Uncle Tony up there, and they're sending some text messages with maybe the score, the update. Yeah, that was a brutal match, that one against Coria. Not to mention the fact, Dick, that Nadal had blisters on his hitting hand, on his left hand, throughout the last couple rounds of that tournament. He's able to fight through it, but he's in trouble here now, 15-40.
Federer set to pounce, get the early break.
From Nadal there.
And it's Federer in the lead in the fourth. Nadal leads 2-1. And he's hungry to win this title and complete the career Grand Slam. First time ever as a pro for Nadal to play here in France, which
he
is...
He seems a little nervous, doesn't he, by the occasion. He's amazing, this kid, Nadal, on his 19th birthday here, playing the first time at Roland Garros. Clearly, these are the two favorites coming in. And Roger Federer, as you said, Dick, trying to capture that fourth slam. He's, of course, won four overall, two Wimbledons, one in the U.S., one in Australia. And, you know, both players were absolutely dominant coming into this semifinal, and we expected a match like this, I think, very close. Nadal, obviously, now with the 2-1 lead, but here's Federer right back with a break here in the fourth.
Federer needs to win this set and then fifth set in order to claim a chance for the finals of the French. First part of the job has been completed, the break of Nadal.
That caught the line there. Earlier on, we talked about the keys to victory for Nadal. Dictate with the forehand. The sets he's won, he's been able to do that. Attack Federer's backhand, but oftentimes by opening up, going to the forehand side and a high first serve percentage. Nadal's first serve percentage at 69% for the match. So that's been there.
Out.
But I'm surprised, the one thing I'm surprised about, Dick, is how many errors Federer's made on that forehand side. Thought that that would be a key for Nadal to get to the forehand and then go off to the backhand, but that's 28 unforced errors now on the Federer forehand side.
And a total of 51 errors in the match. For Nadal.
That, of course, is the danger of going to the Federer forehand, but that's the risk you must take. And Federer had the answer, slapping it up the line.
And the 19-year-old is fearless in his attack. He certainly doesn't play to not lose.
No. That's wide.
Such an important play. We've seen it throughout the championship for men and women. You want to win here in Paris and get deep into the tournament, then you better be able to execute that drop shot. Late call. Some of the fans disagree.
Nadal is saying it was good. They're going to replay the point. Nadal. Great sportsmanship both guys have shown in this match. Cannon shot spot confirms that one caught the line.
The fans rightfully applaud Nadal for being such a sporting fellow. Listen to this. Makes you feel good.
French fans, finally they got something right here. Be ornery crowd sometimes. I appreciate their good tennis.
And the late call is confirmed by Cedric Maurier in the chair. And Federer locks in the game after breaking the doll. It's 3-1. The very fact that Nadal would show that sporting gesture to go up and indicate that that play was good is just another of the qualities that make him so endearing. He just seems to, for 19, to know so much and do so many things right.
He just wants to go out there and battle, and he wants to win the right way. He enjoys the competition. He enjoys the big stage.
Mama Ana Maria has to be proud.
Be proud, win or lose.
We're closing in on 9 o'clock here in Paris. 1-3 in the fourth. Should it go five, there's some doubt as to the ability to finish tonight. These are two international stars. They say in Spain, the telecasts of the matches of Nadal rate right with those of Spanish football. That's pretty high.
That's like National Football League in our country. Oh, he's got that. Oh, but he missed it.
And that was for 30 all.
Yes.
That's a moment you won't see in many of Federer's entire matches, missing one that easy.
Set.
I'd sleep over and I didn't bring my teddy and my blankie yet.
That's okay. We just set up shop right here.
Not a bad couple of guests found a sleepover. Mr. Federer,
yep.
Mr. Nadal. Roger Federer, 3-2 in the fourth.
We're still a ways away from that, though, with the way Nadal's been working over the Federer serve. The second serve. Federer able to win that second serve point. He's up a bit though, Dick. He's pumped up the numbers. He's up to 41% now on second serve points won. He was in the high 20s a while ago, so that's good news for him.
It's about 64% on his first serve. As if he was lining that one up to go down the line.
I think that was exactly what was going through his head. It seems like there are times when he's second-guessing himself on that shot.
Oh, and yes. No second-guessing there. Clean winner, his third ace. You see behind him almost 2.5 hours into the match. Getting a first serve in this game.
Yes.
Coach Roach sees his man a point away from 4-2 in the fourth. His head missing when having so much time on that drop shot. Roach with one of those, can you believe that looks? And another missed first serve. Fan shouting from the crowd and interrupted Federer's rhythm.
You know, the crowd working over that fan, and well, they should, but still, Federer's got to be able to collect himself there. Five doubles now.
Umpire Moyer asking for respect and in his own way chastising that fan. It's deuce. He gotten in the first serve in this entire game.
He had that one ace, and
that's right.
Yeah, but other than that, that's it. He got it. And the
Federer furious with himself. Again, he had a lot to work with there, and he's sort of forced into the net after the net court, and that just gave Nadal time.
Look how low he is on that backhand. Federer made a great play there just to keep the point alive. Here's the break point, Nadal to get back even here in the fourth. Another miss for a serve.
Oh. That's a great shot. That works so much better on the clay. Get the angle forehand approach for Federer rather than trying to hit through the court, hitting the ball short with all that topspin and then moving forward, getting Nadal off the court.
Wow. And he's walking a slippery path now. Another break point for Nadal.
He's really struggling on his serve. He's only made four first serves in the set, Federer, in play. Look at all the errors on that forehand side.
And he misses the first serve again.
Oh, boy. Unbelievable that we can miss those.
The break back. Nadal accepting the donation from Federer.
Federer wants, I think he's either ticked off at the fan who yelled at him that cost him or that helped cause that double fall. Remember, he was up 40-15 in that game, Federer, and he played a couple of really loose points. And I wonder if he's also talking to the umpire about maybe the darkness. I think he's more focusing on that fan, but the umpire can't do anything. He did what he could do. Made an announcement after the fact.
So the lead for Federer here in the fourth erased. Nadal back on course 3-all, leading 2-1.
Nadal at this point almost play Federer's forehand.
Running out of daylight after 9 o'clock in Paris. It's a lot darker on court than our camera lens is would indicate. We're opening those lenses up.
How much daylight's left in Roger Federer's game at this point?
I think they'll want to, the umpire and the tournament referee, to at least get this fourth set in the book.
You don't get the feeling that Nadal's going to fold under the pressure if he has the chance to close this out. Not at all.
Federer to produce an error, just big long looping shots from Nadal's end.
Federer is really self-destructing here. Okay, Nadal's getting the ball deep. He's hit some passing shots, but the last two games he's just keeping the ball in play.
That's what he did in the first set. See the lights on now in the portals here at Chatrier Stadium. Three all, 30 all in the fourth.
Ah. continues to let Federer hit a lot of balls until the air. It's 4-3 in the fourth.
Stefan Franzen, the supervisor, and Federer has been talking to the umpire during this last changeover about the darkness.
But Morier says reprise, so play continues.
It's not what you want to be thinking about when you're about to step up to the line at 3-4, two sets to one down. And Federer's got to try to keep his focus here. So many errors on the forehand side.
Total of 60 in the match. Only 32 by his opponent.
34 from Federer on the forehand. Come back tomorrow after that.
Like an audience at the Opera House saluting a winning aria. How does he even get his racket on the ball? That was Nadal's best stuff. Heavy right low at his ankles.
Oh, what a shot.
He just covers so much court and then produces that kind of reply off a shot Federer must have thought was going to be a winner. Fortune for Federer.
Oh, he is really ticked off now. Yeah, like everything's going against him with the darkness coming, Nadal's ability to retrieve a net cord, fan yelling in between first and second. A test for this champion. It's right here, right now, for Roger Federer.
Federer's mother, Lynette. She and Roger's dad, Robert, met while his father was working in South Africa. She is South African and the father, a Swiss. That's wide, and here's a break point for Nadal, which would give him a chance then, if converted, to serve it out for the finals. Huge point in the late afternoon, early evening in Paris. Number one in trouble. Service, and now the 19-year-old birthday boy from Mallorca will serve for the finals of the French Open.
Well, Roger Federer has been second-guessing himself throughout, and look what he does here. He started to run around and hit the forehand, and then he changed his mind, and he couldn't get into position. And Nadal says, 4 points from the final in his first ever appearance at this tournament. Says, I'm ready to take it.
Yeah, no, this is it.
He's done a nice job, Dick, of letting Federer make errors, but at the same time, when he gets something to hit, going for it.
Plenty of pop on that last forehand this late in the match, 244. 3 points from victory.
Court ball in the forehand into the forehand corner has been the X factor in this match.
Another cry of vamos. The entire season, and certainly throughout this French Open Championship, every point played as if it was the last point, and now it is possibly the last point on his birthday to win his way into the French Open Finals. Oh my. He's cool, doesn't hurry, takes his time, despite the pressure of the moment. Southpaws for the French Open title on Sunday. Any doubts about his game? Or he has the right stuff.
Or his attitude. I mean, that was so impressive, Dick, that last game. Just the way, as you noted, he took his time. He cranked the forehand. He was not going to let Federer lose it. He won it.
His 23rd consecutive win. That ties the most ever by a teenager in the Open era. Andre Agassi, 17 years ago. And Roger Federer dismissed at times his own worst enemy, but he lost on this late Friday night
to the better player.
Well, you have to wonder, Dick, if he'll ever be able to. I mean, obviously, he's won big titles on clay, but he really second-guessed himself a lot in this match. And this kid, he's only going to get better. How scary is that?
Swimming in the dirt, Chris Fowler.
All right, Dick and Patrick, thank you. Happy birthday is being sung, by the way, to Rafael Nadal behind us here. Wow, Brad, as the sun sets over here on his 19th birthday, it really is perhaps a new dawn in Grand Slam tennis. It's rare to see Roger Federer disheveled, walking off the court, confused, frustrated, and well beaten by a guy that you predicted earlier this week would win between 7 and 10 slams in his career. That's a whole lot of hype. And
I said all along, it's about substance, and this kid's going to be a legend. A legend was born today. Roger Federer has an equal.
Yeah, it was epic because it's not just beating the number one player in the world. It's handling the occasion, his first Grand Slam semifinal, and knowing that in this fourth set, with the light rapidly disappearing and Federer talking to the chair umpire, that if he didn't break Federer and serve it out, he was probably going to have to sleep on it.
Well, how about the last game? Three clean winners. Very calm. I mean, he doesn't have 140-mile-an-hour serve. He has to hit shots. He was incredibly calm. That's what I love about this kid. Special under pressure. He rises to the level.
Now, this wasn't a final, even though it felt like it. There's still some work to be done on Sunday. It'd be the humongous favorite against the other lefty in the match, Mariano Puerta. So we still have some business to handle to win this first slam.
Well, he's 2-0 against him and gave him a woodshed in Acapulco about 3 months ago, 4-1. He's a huge favorite. I expect him to handle the pressure. I think Puerta's obviously got nothing to lose, but the only thing he's got to lose is looking at Nadal on the other side.
A woodshed. I think there's going to be a lot of woodshed beatings delivered in the end.
Oh, he's going to give a lot of them in his career.
Rafael Nadal. What a birthday in Paris. Nadal through to Sunday's final, beating Federer in 4. Back after this.
Term life, annuities, long-term care. I can't make any sense of this. Can you do it?
I did a checkbook.
Black group, and we'll play the number two player in the red group, who, let's face it, could be playing better than the number one. I mean, the
that's right.
Red group's so wacky.
Another drop shot winner. Well, Serena's in the red group for sure.
But not necessarily
the top player.
One, yeah.
Exactly. It all depends on the Mesquita Dimensiva match.
Yeah, so Moresmo could play Davenport or Williams in the number two spot.
Mesquita loses, Davenport wins the group and would be the top player and play
Sharapova. She's overplaying that shot. It's about the fourth attempt.
Missed the overhead and it's 30 all.
I mean, she had plenty of time to get there and hit a good two-handed backhand. She's just sort of having a hoot of a time with that shot today. Just a kid, 17. I want to have fun out there.
Show off a little bit.
Yeah.
And the squeak, the squeal, or the grunt, whatever you call it, is not there. I mean, she hasn't.
But we haven't seen the last of it this week.
No.
That's an example of Moresmo's serve when she kind of drops that left arm down the head, a little bit like the way Venus gets into trouble with her second serve. This obviously scintillating action for the woman on the right of your screen. Better, she just wants to get close.
Break point.
The ball toss has been an issue for Moresmo throughout her career. Trying to get a consistent toss.
One apiece.
Okay.
Dubai duty-free match summary. Winners and unforced errors. Bigger numbers for both Sharapova. Look at that strange break point total. Not one break point has been lost by either player. That's unusual.
Yesterday, Marez was able to fight off all the break points against her, eight of them.
Now she can't fight off any. It's
incredible.
Goofy.
One day to the next.
First set, early break in the second, and then an immediate break back by Sharapova, one apiece, 30-15.
So I can do it at that time.
But a lot more goes into a...